So we're going to talk about budgeting and scheduling. So there's several ways you can go about this, and it's very simple either way, to be honest with you. So as you can see here, you have a daily budget amount and you have a lifetime budget amount. Now, each one has its own benefits and features that it unlocks, and I'll show you those real quick. So, as you can see here with the lifetime, you set the dates when it begins, when it ends. You set the amount. Now, the one thing that this unlocks is the ad scheduling. As you can see here, it says ad scheduling only works with lifetime budgets. So, the benefit of this is, if you don't want your ads showing 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, you would not be able to adjust your timing with a daily budget. So within the lifetime budget, it allows you to go and adjust things, as you can see accordingly, right? We have 12 a.m. on Monday. So when you when you actually make the actual portion dark, as you can see here, it says scheduled hours. So now we're selecting the days and times that we want. So if you know that there's certain days and times that are better for your crowd and who we want to target, then set them accordingly. Now, I know for a fact, usually, now every market's different, so normally, I don't like to advertise between the 12 and 4 a.m. type period. That just does not usually attract the crowd that I'm going for. That does not mean that there is not value within this crowd and who is awake at those times doing what they need to do or whatever. But for me and the things that I've done and the things, the campaigns that we've ran, I just don't get near the results within these hours that I do from 5 o'clock on. Now, like I said, obviously you'll know your market and you'll know the type of people you're dealing with. So we'll get into looking at the times that are best for your campaign and how to look at those. But at the same time, you know, you could let it run 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, because maybe you feel, hey, I just want to let it go and try to catch everything I can. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying you won't have success or that you will be as successful as you can be. But me personally, I just know that there's times when we've wasted money within these hours and, you know, we didn't get the results that we essentially were expecting. So, or anticipated, or the kind that we usually get during these ones. So keep that in mind. Now, the next portion that shows right here under delivery type, just keep this throughout the as it is set right here. Show your ads throughout your selected schedule. Right here, even if you have this 24 hours a day, this will just go in rotation. Whereas if you try to go through accelerated, as you can see here, shows your ads as quickly as possible. So it's almost force feeding your ads to get to your demographic. Now, there's nothing wrong with this. So the only time that I would really utilize this is if there was a pressing event or some type of scenario where I wanted people to see this quickly and my motivation reason is whatever. I would do something to this effect. But normally, I just keep this standard, and that's what you're going to want to do also. Now, within this section, you'll see right here that it is saying optimization for ad delivery. We're going for leads, right? We're going to utilize the actual lead ad generation platform within Facebook for what we're learning now. There are other ways to get leads through Facebook, utilizing funnels and other types of capture pages. And we will go over that in other bonus modules. But for the sake of this course, being able to get started and get started right away, we will be utilizing the lead ad generation platform through Facebook. So our objection is optimization for ad delivery. We want to keep it on leads, right? We don't want to go with link clicks. We want, really, this is what we want. We want leads. Now, I like to leave it automatic. As you can see here, it says, let Facebook set the bid that helps you get the most results at the best price. To me, I think Facebook knows a little bit more than I do. Now, if I notice that my cost per lead is getting outrageous, then obviously I would come and adjust this. And when I say outrageous, you know what you're willing to pay per lead, right? Essentially, you're going to say, hey, for every 10 leads, I get one loan. Or for every 20 leads, I get one loan, right? So in the first scenario, you were at a 10% close ratio. Second scenario, you're at a 5% close ratio. So you could equate that to what you're willing to spend per lead. Now, you could go in here and set your manual cost, right? Now there's going to be a suggested bid that they give, and you could utilize that if you choose to. But like I said, I like to utilize the automatic portion. I believe that Facebook is a little more in tune with certain things than we are, but I would change this manually if essentially it got too high. So automatic goes, and that's how we're able to get the leads, usually around $5 to $10 per cost per acquisition of each lead. Now, it does vary when you start going after certain demographics and particular career paths, but this is what we always utilize. So that would be the essential portion of budgeting and schedule. On to the next video.